those of us in the know, we know the wicked to be who? Esau, the so-called white man, right? So that's who this ungodly is speaking of right here again. When the ungodly, or the so-called white man, curseth Satan, he curseth his own soul. See? Giving credence to the idea of the so-called white man actually being the physical counterpart to the spiritual being Satan. See? Which brings me right here. To the book of 2 Thessalonians, the second chapter, and starting at the third verse, it says, let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come. What day? The great and notable day of our Lord Yahushua at his return, when he returned in all his glory and power and majesty and splendor and honor and effort to overthrow the wicked and stake his rightful claim, you know, his ownership over the planet Earth and beyond. All right, that's this day that the scripture is emphasizing again. It says, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away first. Yeah, and that prophecy was fulfilled at the falling of the so-called Negro, Latino, and Native American being brought to ruin and scattered abroad. See? And ultimately going into captivity under the foot of our arch enemy and nemesis, the so-called white man. See? Again, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. So we are to look out for a man. Let's read this again. It says, let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away first. And that prophecy was fulfilled. It says, and that man